last one, most of all because it actually shows us Venom. So let's start with that last shot first. The reveal of Venom in all his hulking, grotesque glory. The character's look is pretty dead on to his comic book counterpart, with his large white eyes, giant maw full of razor-sharp teeth, and serpentine tongue. It really is the classic Venom look. What we can't quite make out, even in the preceding shot of Eddie Brock lying on the street, his body becoming encased in the symbiote, is whether there's any sort of white marking on his chest, but it doesn't look like it. However, you can definitely see what appears to be white veins coursing through his body. We do get several shots of the symbiote's powers in action when the Life Foundation's goons pay Eddie a visit at home to retrieve their boss's merchandise, only to have the Venom symbiote's tentacles lash out from Eddie's arms and back to take out his foes. When compared to the first trailer, this Venom preview does a hell of a better job on showing who this character is and what he's capable of in just a few brief shots. But this trailer isn't designed as a visual effects showcase, but rather a story synopsis. So let's go back to the start. It opens with the same crash site glimpsed in the first trailer before establishing Eddie Brock's normal life before becoming Venom. We get a look at Michelle Williams as his love interest, possibly an ex and presumably a lawyer, whose firm represents, in Eddie's view, the bad guys. He's right about them being bad guys because the trailer proceeds to chart the journey of that canister containing the symbiote from the crash site, then into the possession of Carlton Drake, played by Rogue One's Riz Ahmed. He's the boss of the Life Foundation, an organization based in San Francisco which seems benevolent to the outside, but has a nefarious, hidden agenda. Drake, we're told, believes the union between human and symbiote is the key to our evolution. Dun dun dun! Tom Hardy's narration reveals Eddie Brock is an investigative reporter who follows people who do not want to be followed. We see Eddie interviewing Drake, putting him on the spot about the Life Foundation's secret experiments and how he recruits the most vulnerable for tests that end up killing people. This example of gotcha journalism prompts Drake to cancel the interview and storm off. Eddie will not be getting a Christmas card from this guy. Eddie's initially contentious encounter with Jenny Slate's scientist character leads him back to the Life Foundation, where she reveals some of the experiments they have been up to. We see at least three individuals who are serving as human hosts for the symbiotes and will presumably become villains Venom will confront later. We know the movie is based on the Lethal Protected Limited comic series, wherein Venom, now an anti-hero, protected San Francisco from five symbiotes spawned by the Venom symbiote itself. The woman attacking and infecting Eddie could be the movie's version of either Donna Diego, who becomes the symbiote called Scream in the comics, or maybe Leslie Gesneria, who is the host for the symbiote Agony. The guys trapped upright might be Raymond Hernandez, who becomes the symbiote Lasher, or maybe he's either Carl Mack, who becomes Phage, or Trevor Cole, aka Riot. This guy in the cell might also be one of those Marvel characters. But you know who's notably absent from all this? No, it's not Spider-Man. Woody Harrelson, who we know is in the movie in a hush-hush role. Rumor has it he's playing Cletus Cassidy, a serial killer who becomes the host for the symbiote Carnage, and it was so bad he makes Venom seem good. Considering Lethal Protector had five symbiotes, it would still make sense that Cletus is one of the people the Life Foundation is experimenting on, even if we don't see him in this trailer. Eddie's possession by the symbiote makes him incredibly sick, and he begins to hear a voice in his head, also provided by Tom Hardy. This leads to a lot of body horror and psychological dread for Eddie, as the sinister symbiote starts to take hold of him, and Eddie starts to refer to himself as we.
Why would we do that?
We see what Eddie stands to lose, namely the woman he loves, and then a series of shots of him eluding pursuers through the streets of San Francisco. And although captured by Carlton Drake here, Eddie's still enough of a gent to warn his nemesis that he should be scared. Eddie bargains with the symbiote, with his new inner voice declaring that we can do whatever we want. Judging from all this desperate thrashing and fevered anguish he's going through here, Eddie's clearly engaged in a Jekyll and Hyde-like war, with this monstrous darkness consuming him. Eddie ultimately makes a deal with the devil. If it's to remain within him, then it can only hurt bad people. But as these closing shots again demonstrate, this is a beast that cannot be caged. The symbiote is now fully manifesting, cocooning itself around Eddie's body until it swallows him whole. And yep, there's that handsome kisser again. We are Venom, it declares in a line that sounds a dark inversion of famous superhero movie lines like I am Iron Man or I'm Batman. It now makes so much sense that this was the hashtag Venom's social accounts have been pushing in recent months. As the trailer's tagline drives home, Eddie Brock will have to embrace his inner anti-hero if he's to stop the Life Foundation and presumably the other symbiotes from wreaking any more havoc.